CIET NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 2.
Hello dear children, how are you all? Hope you all are doing great and you are in good health. I know you all are missing your school, your friends, your teachers, how you used to learn mathematics together in your classrooms. But don't worry, I'm your friend Rajni, and I have come here to teach you some new things in a fun-filled manner. So are you all ready to learn new things with me? Yes, your friend Rajni. Today, we are going to have lot of fun-filled learning. Are you all excited? Are you all ready? Good! So, dear children, today we shall learn some more things about Chapter 1. What is long? What is round? Yes, what is long? What is round? Of Class 2. In this chapter, we shall be learning about the shape of things, like different things have different shapes. Also, we shall be learning more about long and round things. Also, we shall be learning about the things which rolls, about the things which slide, and about the things which both roll and slides. I hope you remember what we had learnt in this chapter in our previous session. Remember? The wheels on the bus go round and round, round and round, round and round, all day long. Remember? We had lot of fun in last session. Now let me know if you still remember what we had learnt in the last session of the chapter. What is long? What is round? So are you all ready? Good! You all know that different things have different shapes and sizes. Now I'm going to name some things and you have to tell me about the shape of those things. The shape can be round, it can be long, it can be flat. If you remember, in the last session, we had played cricket with Raju. Now, can you name the two things with which we play cricket? Oh, great! So quickly you gave the correct answer. Bat and ball. Tell me, do they look alike? Look alike means same in shape and size. So tell me, do ball and bat look alike? Oh yes, they do not look alike. Both have different shapes and sizes. Now tell me, what is the shape of a ball? I'm giving you two options and you have to choose the correct option. Now tell me, what is the shape of a ball? Round or long? Oh great! Round shape. Dear kids, round shape is a shape that is curved and have no edges. Now tell me, what is the shape of a bat? Round or long? Absolutely correct! Long! The shape of a bat is long. Now tell me, what is the shape of an orange? Do you like to eat an orange? Oh, me too. Juicy oranges. Now quickly tell me, what is the shape of an orange? Round or long? Yes, round shape. Good answer. Okay, the next question is, what is the shape of an apple? Absolutely correct. Round shape. Do you know what apple says? I will tell you. An apple says, I'm round. I roll on the ground. And when I turn around, I still remain round. Have you noticed, dear kids? If you roll an apple on the ground, it still remains round. Good. I hope you like it. So, the shape of an apple is round. Now tell me, what is the shape of a bottle? Absolutely correct. Long. Do you know, one of my little friends once shared a bottle song with me. Do you all listen to that song? Oh yes, you want to listen to that song. Okay, let's sing together. I have one bottle, green color bottle, long, long bottle. I love my water bottle. Let's repeat. I have one bottle, green color bottle, long, long bottle. I love my water bottle. I hope you all like it. You're doing so well. Clap for you all. All right, dear children, now think and tell me, can you break one single stick? Yes, and that too very easily. Good. Okay, what if I tie two sticks together? Can you still break them? Yes, you are so strong. Good. And what if I tie three sticks together? Yes. Oh, you are so strong. But, dear kids, if I tie 10 sticks together, will you still be able to break that bundle of sticks? No. Because a bundle of 10 sticks is too strong to be broken. Now tell me, are you all strong? Oh, great! You are very strong because you drink milk every day, you eat green vegetables, you exercise daily, so you are strong. Now kids, do you want to know how a postcard, how a postcard made itself stronger? So, listen to this beautiful short story. Dear kids, once there was a postcard and a paintbrush. Dear kids, do you know what is a postcard? Postcard is a piece of thick paper or thin cardboard, and it has four corners. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Four corners. If you haven't seen a postcard, ask your mother or father to show you a postcard. We send messages through the postcard to our known people. So once there was a postcard and a paintbrush. I hope you all have seen a paintbrush. It is used for painting. So once a paintbrush asked the postcard, "Can you make me stand on you, dear postcard?" The postcard says, "Yes, I can." So, the postcard stood straight and asked the paintbrush to stand on it. But as the paintbrush tried to stand on it, it fell down. It tried again, but again it fell down. So, the paintbrush said, "Oh, you cannot make me stand on you. It's okay." The postcard said,
"No, no, wait a minute."
The postcard asked its another friend to roll it and stick the ends together using a sellotape. As the friend of postcard helped it rolled and tied its end together, the postcard became stronger. It asked the paintbrush to then stand on it because the flat surface area got increased, and this time the paintbrush could easily stand on it. Now, dear kids, you can even try this at your home. You just need to take a postcard or a thin piece of cardboard. Just roll it properly and stick the ends together using a sellotape or glue, and it's ready. Do you know, this rolled postcard can even lift the weight of a book? You can even see the picture of this stronger postcard in chapter 1 of your math magic book of class 2. So kids, I hope you liked doing this activity. Alright, now we are going to learn another beautiful concept about what rolls, what slides. This topic is also in chapter 1 of your math magic book class 2. Now let's see what all I have for you lovely children in my magic bag today. I have made a small slide using an exam board and kept it in a slanting position, taking support of the wall. It's just in front of me. You all must have enjoyed the slide ride in any of the parks. For doing this experiment, you too can make a slide at your home using an exam board or any other flat board to check if the things slide or roll over the board. Now I'm putting my hand into the magic bag and let's see what comes out of the bag. Magic bag, magic bag, what do you have? Oh, I got an orange. Let's check if the orange slides or rolls. So now I'm putting this orange on the top of this slide I have made, and I left the orange and it rolled. Lovely. So an orange has a round shape and it rolls. But have you noticed, kids, if you keep the orange in a topside down position, it can even slide sometimes. Let's see what comes next. Again, I'm putting my hand into the magic bag. Magic bag, magic bag, what do you have? This time, I got a mobile phone. Now let's check if this mobile phone rolls or slides. So I'm putting it on the top of the slide. and I left it. Can you guess if it slides or rolls? Yes, you are right. Mobile phone slides. Mobile phone has a flat surface and things with flat surface slides. So, did you get it? Things with flat surfaces slide. Now let's sing again. Magic bag, what do you have? Oh, this time it's a tomato. Red, red tomato. Can you tell me what is the shape of a tomato? Correct. It is round in shape. Now tell if the tomato rolls or it slides. Yes, it rolls. Tell me, why? Because round things roll. As tomato is round in shape, so it rolls. Now tell me about our next thing. It is a pencil. Tell me if the round shaped pencil rolls or it slides. Now I'm keeping this pencil in the vertical position, that is, in the straight up and down position on the top of the slide. So what happens? Oh, it's coming down, sliding. But if you keep the pencil in a horizontal position, then what happens? It comes down, tumbling and tumbling, rolling. So, the round-shaped pencil both roll and slide. Can you name any other thing that can roll and slide as well? Think. Tell me quickly. I am waiting. Great! Coin. Coin can roll as well as slide. Okay, now tell me, can you roll? Oh yes, you like rolling. Okay, tell me, can you slide? Yes, even I can roll and slide. Do you know a coin can also spin like a ball? Okay. Now stand up and tell me, can you spin like a coin? Oh, lovely. You can spin. Now tell me, can you spin a coin? If you don't know how to spin a coin, don't worry. You can learn it by practicing. You can spin a 1 rupee coin, a 2 rupee coin, or even a 5 rupee coin. Alright, now let's quickly recall the things which roll, the things which slide, and the things which both slide and roll. I shall name some things and you give me the correct answer. So, ready children? Okay, what about ball? Yes, ball rolls. Table? Table slides. What about glass? Glass rolls as well as slides. What about notebook? Notebook slides. What about tire? Tire rolls as well as slides. What about orange? Juicy orange. Orange both roll and slide. Bag slides. Yes, you all are lovely children and giving the correct answers. Tell me, what about pipe? Pipe rolls as well as slides. Box. Box slides. Coin. We have already learnt about coin. Quickly tell me the answers. Yes, coin rolls as well as slides. What about cylinder? Cylinder rolls. Very good. You are doing so well. Now, children, we are going to play tower making game. Yes, tower making game. So, are you all ready to play this game? All right. Look around in your house and quickly collect things such as boxes of different kinds, balls, erasers, matchboxes, mobile phones, everything for making tower. Till then, I'm singing these lines for you. Look around, find out the things. Till you fetch the things, I will sing, sing, sing. So go quickly and look for the things. Look around, find out the things. Till you fetch the things, I will sing, sing, sing. Great! You all brought the things so quickly. I do have some things with me here. Okay, now you have to separate the things which are flat and the things which are not flat or round in shape. So, on one side of mine, I have three matchboxes, two books, two boxes, and on the other side, I have two balls, one apple, and one tomato. All right, let's start making the tower. You like to play this game? Good. First, I am putting one book on the table. And then I am putting another book on it. Now I am putting a box. Then another box on it. Be careful. Then I am putting all the three matchboxes on one another. First matchbox, second matchbox, and slowly third matchbox. Oh, such a tall tower of the things with the flat surfaces. Now I am making another tower with all the round things. You also try to make the tower with round things at your home. So, I am keeping one ball at the bottom. Then, on it, I am putting the tomato. Oops! It fell down. Don't worry, I will try again. Now, I am again trying to put the orange, this time on the ball. Oh, it fell down again. That means we cannot make tower with the round shaped things. Okay, now you quickly go into the balcony and stand near your gate. Now look around and tell me which is the tallest building in your area. Don't go out of the house. See from your balcony or near the gate. Can you see any building? From my place, I can see a two-story building, one three-story building, and another five-story building. Now, can you tell me which is the tallest building? Two-story building, three-story building, or five-story building? Oh, yes! Five-story building is the tallest building. Do you have trees around you? Look around and tell me, which is the tallest tree around you? Oh, I can hear you saying people tree, coconut tree. Oh, now you know about the tallest things. Okay, now tell me, if I make a tower of 10 matchboxes on one side and a tower of 4 matchboxes on the other side. Did you listen carefully? A tower of 10 matchboxes on one side and a tower of 4 matchboxes on the other side. So, which set of matchboxes will make the tallest tower? Think. Yes, tallest tower will be made with 10 matchboxes. You are doing so good. I hope you enjoyed this session. So, children, today we learned about the shape of different things. The shape can be round or long. Also, we learnt about the things which roll, which slides, and the things which both slide and roll. Now, I'm giving you one simple activity to do at home. You have to draw pictures of two things that roll, two things that slide, and two things that both roll and slide. Also, write their names. I know you will draw them beautifully. So now I'm leaving, but I will soon meet you in another fun-filled session. Till then, you enjoy and take care. Bye-bye.
You are just listening to curriculum-based programs, Dhwani Shala. Production assistants, Meenakshi Kukreti and Jagbandhu Jana. Recorded by Bati Langlingdo and Shanu Muksim. Produced by Ajit Horo. This program was brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.